Boxing King Media, powered by BYD. Delighted to be joined by Mr. Andy Cruz. How are you, sir? Fourth fight in Los Angeles.
Mi cuarta pelea. Estoy muy feliz, muy motivado de este gran evento y con ganas de que ya llegue el sábado.
I'm really happy. I'm excited to be part of such a big event, and I can't wait for Saturday to come around.
A lot of people rate you as one of the best technical fighters in the world right now, even though you've only had, like, this is going to be your fourth fight. You've got so much hype and so much limelight around your name. You will have seen with Canelo, even Usyk recently, they've tried to learn English. How important is that for you to try and pick up English and be able to speak it, like, you know, in the next few months or years?
En parte, escogí también entrenar mis campamentos en Philly porque pienso que se podría aprender el inglés mucho más rápido. Creo que es importante también, ya que también me permitirá cómo dirigirme al público de boxeo, también a los amantes de boxeo en inglés, y por eso poco a poco voy aprendiendo. Creo que es cuestión de tiempo para dominarlo.
No, you know, it was quite uppermost in my mind when I was choosing places to actually have my training camps, and partly behind that was this kind of point you mentioned there about speaking English. I thought that, you know, training there would open up doors and give me a chance to learn the language a little bit more, because I think it is important. I do want to make myself available and kind of direct myself, if you like, to the English speaking boxing audience, and in some part maybe that was influential in that decision on where to train.
And have you picked up any English? Can you put any sort of sentence together at all in English yet?
Bueno, realmente mi dificultad es como comunicarme, ¿no? Aún hablar con otra persona me es un poco difícil, pero cuando me hablan a mí, siempre logro captar muchas cosas.
You know, it's always the same. I think when you actually want to communicate and me speak, that's where it becomes a bit difficult. I'm actually making good progress on understanding and my comprehension. When people speak to me, I'm doing fine, but it's just a bit harder the other way around.
I'm pretty sure as you pick up, you know, fans will find it intriguing. I'm going to say something to you, which most of our fans are British, they'll watch this. I don't know if you can relay this back and just say, you know, all right, geezer. It's like a typical London saying.
Well, you want him to say that back, yeah?
All right, geezer. Oh, okay.
See, you can speak it. There you go. That was really good. So, you know, you signed... Very good. You signed with Eddie Hearn. What was the main reason you signed with Eddie Hearn? Because every promoter was after you.
Porque fue el que más pasión me mostró. Creo que de todos los que estaban interesados, él era el que más quería. De hecho, antes de ser campeón olímpico, yo no sabía quién era y ya él me había escrito, ¿sabes? Él sabía. Y cuando llegué acá, que dije, Eddie Hearn, ¿dónde he escuchado ese nombre? Y miré mi Instagram de hacía 3 años atrás y ya él me había escrito, me había dicho, hey, Andy Cruz. Antes de ser campeón olímpico me decía, hey, Andy Cruz, ¿quieres ser profesional? ¿Quieres mostrando interés en mí? Y dije, wow, creo que él es el que mejor va a velar por mis intereses.
You know what? It's interesting. I think he's the guy. I always knew he was going to be the guy who would fight for my interests more than anyone. There were other promoters interested, as you say, but I look back in my kind of address, you know, my what you call it, inbox, and even before I was Olympic champion, Eddie had been in touch, writing to me, saying, "Do you want to sign? Do you want to turn professional? Do you want to sign with me?" And that was even before I became Olympic champion. So when we actually, when he did make contact after that, and when I was deciding, I thought, "Hang on, Eddie, I know that name. I know." And I looked back, and I could see that he had shown interest then, and I think he showed altogether more passion than anyone for me and for the sport. So that's why.
I used to watch your Instagram lives before you was a professional boxer, and you should see that you used to like go live on Instagram and used to maybe drink a few, I don't know what you was drinking, maybe tequila, I'm not sure, but you know, after fights, and it looked like you come from like a difficult upbringing in a way. When I used to see where you used to live, how difficult was your life then, and how is it improved now since you become a professional?
Sí, siempre he dicho que lo fácil no tiene mérito. Al principio siempre es difícil, como he dicho en otras entrevistas, muchas personas ven la victoria, el logro, pero no ven el sacrificio que hay detrás, ¿sabes? Y hay muchos sacrificios, y por supuesto que cuando se logra el objetivo, la victoria, es que vale la pena todo el sacrificio. Es que ves que el sacrificio ha valido la pena.
El sacrificio, la última palabra.
Ahí es que ves que el sacrificio ha valido la pena.
Oh, yeah. So, basically, I think it's really beneficial in a way to have things tough at the beginning. There's a saying that, you know, having it easy is never a good thing. Having it too easy, it doesn't bode well for the future. I think hardship, sacrifice earlier on in your career makes success even more sweet. I think having it tough and living through those tough times that you refer to is a really worthwhile thing along the way to help you to be successful.
Could you share maybe a story with us, like, so people can kind of picture what it was like for him? Because I'll give you an example. Maurizio Lara told me a long time ago, when he used to fight in his early fights, he used to go into the changing rooms, and the changing rooms had like dirty mattresses in there, and like, you know, there was no toilet, or you'd warm up outdoors, and, you know, like it wasn't easy. Then obviously he used to sell things with his mum as well. I can't remember what, but he used to sell something like that. Yeah, something like that. So just curious to know what, if you can give us an example of how hard it was.
Because
it may inspire the next generation of Cubans.
En Cuba, todos saben las dificultades que se viven en Cuba. En Cuba hay un exceso de talento, mucho talento, pero faltan muchos equipos, ¿sabe? Y falta de condiciones, equipos, lo que es equipo para uno prepararse. No hay tanta tecnología como en otros países. Y es muy difícil. La vida allá es muy difícil. La economía es un poco baja también, ¿sabes? Muchas veces, incluso siendo bueno en lo que haces, no puedes darle a la familia todo lo que se merece, y es muy difícil, y hay veces que muchos tienen que salir del país buscando mejores oportunidades.
Fuera del país, sí. No, I suppose, what I would say, first of all, there's an absolute excess in the talent pool that we have in Cuba. There's a, you know, huge amounts of talent out there, but what is lacking are teams of, you know, trainers, you know, people and technology to actually get that talent and progress it to get to the level where it needs to be. So, in other words, I think everyone knows that things are tough economically in Cuba. You know, it's going through tough times at the moment, and so it's difficult. So sometimes you have to kind of look, that talent has to look abroad to be able to, you know, to grow that talent. You have to like look abroad and go and train and do your job elsewhere, type of thing. But it is so much talent, but maybe not enough kind of organized infrastructure to develop that talent.
Did he give any examples of his own personal hardships, whether he had like a second job or anything like that?
Algún ejemplo, he didn't give them, but I can ask him again. Algún ejemplo de sacrificio que tuviste que hacer para entrenar al principio. Está curioso. ¿Tener otro empleo, un segundo empleo?
No. Un principio, gracias a mi familia, a mi mamá, que siempre me lo dio todo a pesar de las dificultades, ¿sabes? Muchas veces no tenía tenis para entrenar. Entrenaba con camisetas rotas, así, sin guantes o con guantes maltratado, ¿sabes? Sin un buen protector, no esas cosas.
Protector aquí. Yeah, I suppose I was lucky, you know. I didn't kind of want for too much, given that my mum sacrificed everything and worked really, really hard to give me a chance. But I suppose I could give a couple of examples. You know, I'd maybe some training sessions. I wouldn't have shoes. You know, trainers to train in. I wouldn't have. You know, the gloves would be worn out and maybe, you know, damaged in some way. You know, you'd be maybe your top that you were wearing or your shirt might be torn or, you know, broken or whatever. So there are a couple of examples, I guess.
Brilliant.
Last question I've got for you. Cuba's known, you know, he said it himself there, Cuba's known for having such a big talent pool, but we've never seen like a really big star in the professional game in recent years from Cuba. We've seen so many fighters nearly make it and they fall short. Why is that, and how do you make sure that you're not one of them, because you've got so much ability?
Primero es que antes no había tanta posibilidad de pelear profesional. De hecho, muchos peleadores no conocían el boxeo profesional. Actualmente, sí, el peleador cubano está más abierto, ¿sabe? Tiene mucho más conocimiento sobre el boxeo profesional y es mucho más fácil cambiar de amateur a profesional. Muchos peleadores que han tenido buen resultado amateur han llegado tarde. Han llegado tarde.
Ah, ok, en su carrera.
Exacto.
Sí.
Al profesional. El enfoque mío está en que yo logré muchas cosas en el amateur gracias a mi sacrificio, gracias a mi dedicación. Y no voy a fracasar en el profesional porque le voy a poner el mismo empeño, ¿sabe? Incluso el doble, ya que sé que el profesional es mucho más exigente, es difícil porque son más rounds, los guantes son más pequeños, ¿sabes? Y uno está arriesgando más en el ring. Así que...
¿Estás haciendo qué más en el ring?
El boxeo profesional, uno se arriesga más. Es más riesgoso en el ring, ¿sabes? Así que no pierdo el enfoque, no pierdo lo que es ese hambre de ser una leyenda de boxeo.
Perfecto, la respuesta muy perfecta. Now, I think nowadays, I think Cuban boxing is a little more open to the rest of the world. I think in the past, and I think Cuban boxers who are at the amateur stage have a little bit more knowledge of the professional game outside of Cuba. So I think it's become a little easier for guys my age now to make that change and to make that step into the professional world. There are some excellent boxers, as we've said, at amateur level, but I think maybe one of the reasons you're after is that maybe they made that change and that step a little bit too late in their careers. So they were a little older when they did that, so it's obviously going to be harder. My focus now is to demonstrate the same sacrifice, effort and ambition that I've, you know, shown proof of in my amateur career. And really almost double the effort that I've put in so far. Now I'm part of the professional game because I've got that desire to succeed even more. We know it's all different. We know we've talked about, you know, the gloves are smaller, there's more rounds in a fight at a professional level. And I think really you're putting more on the line in the professional game. The word I asked him to specify, you're risking, it's a bigger risk every time you step into the ring in the professional game. But that doesn't change anything for me. I've still got that same focus and I've got even more hunger to make sure that I do succeed.
Okay. No more questions? Just tell him for me that this is not a question, just tell him that God's given him amazing ability. He's been blessed with amazing footwork and ability, and I hope he fulfills the potential he's got to become one of the best fighters of this era.
Eso no es una pregunta, es de su corazón.
Okay.
Quiere que tú, Dios, te ha bendido con un talento, con una velocidad de pierna, de pies,
sí,
y con una técnica que no se ve muchas veces en la vida. Yo espero sinceramente que tengas todos los éxitos y que triunfas en tu carrera.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Por el apoyo. Muchas gracias por el apoyo.
Bigging me up massively. And also thanks for the support.
My pleasure. Thank you very much. Okay, brother.